we are going to discuss statistical time division multiplexing. So that is another variation of time division multiplexing. Now at first we shall consider the problem, then we shall go for the solution. In statistical time division multiplexing, slots are dynamically allocated to improve the bandwidth frequency. So that is the main thing. So what is the problem? See, we are having this line A, line B, line C, line D, line E. Consider in the first slot, the channel C is not transmitting any data, and also channel E, line E. Now in the second time slot, you can find that line A and line C, they are not transmitting any data. So if we allocate the respective slots for the frame 1, you can find this one, that here we are having some empty slots are there. Why empty slots? Because if you don't transmit, then also the slots will get allocated. So that is the misuse of our resource. We are allocating a time slot, but during that time slot there will be no data is getting transferred. So that's why there is a problem we are facing. So in this case, what are the lines? They are not transmitting. C and E, you can find that C and E are void. In this case, what are the lines? They are not transmitting. A and C. So A and C, they have remained void. So now we are going for this statistical time division multiplexing. So how does it occur? So here you see again we are having this C and E, they are not transmitting. So that's why A1, B1 and D1, for them only the time slots will be allocated, they will be transmitting. For C and E, no time slot has been allocated. But how can you get the idea that which channel or which line of data is now getting passed? So we are putting some header there. So A, B and D. So A is the header, B is the header and D is the header, to indicate that which respective lines data is being transmitted through the media. So here you can find that A is missing, C is missing. So B is present, D is present and E is present. So we will be writing this one B, B2, D, D2 and E, E2. In this way the frames are making formed, and this is known as statistical time division multiplexing. So in case of synchronous time division multiplexing, we had one problem, but we know that this is our A, B, C, D, E. So there is no need to have any header, but when the respective line is not transmitting, then you are wasting time there, giving a time slice but not getting utilized. That was a problem with synchronous TDM. So that has been resolved in our statistical TDM. So in this video, we have discussed that how this statistical TDM can work. Thanks for watching this video.
Tutorialspoint.com. Simply easy learning.